This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to look at white oak. White oak is one of our more common forest tree species, particularly on upland drier sites in Indiana, although it can be found on a variety of sites across the state. White oak gets to be one of our largest and longest lived oak trees in Indiana, and is important not only for wildlife, but also for timber products across the state. It's a gorgeous tree that can live to be over 400 years old with very attractive, deeply lobed foliage. There's a lot of variation in how deep the lobes are and how many lobes are on the foliage of each tree. Some of it's related to differences in genetics, some of it's where it's growing, how much sunlight it's getting. But nonetheless, this is still a good identification characteristic. The lobes are rounded at the tips, as is the case with most of the white oak group. One of the other characteristics of white oaks, and many of the oak species, is a cluster of terminal buds at the end of the twig, and there'll often be an associated cluster of leaves coming out at this point. Otherwise, the leaves are alternately held and are simple, and as we mentioned, lobed and very variable in that shape of the lobing. The bark on white oak is a light gray and varies a great deal in pattern. So we can have strong ridging, or we may have plates, and we can have all of that on the same tree. But that light gray color and a strong bark pattern is a good characteristic for white oak. We'll typically find white oak, as we mentioned, on upland drier sites, but it can also be found doing very well on lower sites with high soil quality and a fair amount of moisture. White oak's very important for many of our wildlife species, produces high quality timber, and is also a great shade and yard tree for the long term.